The blue Adonis butterfly is one horny motherfucker. It'll seek out a female blue Adonis and rut until it's blown its tiny little mind. But it will not pick any other butterfly. The blue Adonis will go specifically for the virgins. Why does this phenomenon exist in nature? I ain't no scientist. Why is it that every other night I go out and try and do the same thing? Well, that's a different story. You don't have to look too far back to when promiscuity was looked down on. We were all told to be good little boys and girls and wait until marriage before getting our rocks off. Sure, people ignored that, but it was behind closed doors. Now you have tips for better fellatio advertised on the front of magazines. I say the word virgin. You think sweet, innocent, young. Even younger now than ever before. We live in a world where wedding rings are no longer guaranteed for life, and abstinence rings are just plain laughed at. In history, we see whole cultures obsessed with virgins. When the ancient Aztecs were running low on goats, they turned, of course, to virgins to appease their gods. They claimed it was because it was holier, but I think it was just another good reason not to spurn the chief's advances. Among the Kanuzi in Sudan, to make sure they're getting the latest model in fully mint condition, the men will not only marry their brides before puberty, but give them a manual checkover to make sure their chastity is intact. Then, of course, is the most famous virgin of all time, Mary, mother of the Son of God. What must have Joseph thought? One pregnant virgin, every man's worst nightmare. As for me, none of that matters. It isn't a case of purity. Women have orgasms in their sleep without me. It isn't even a case of wanting to pop cherries other men could not. For me, it all comes down to four little words. Who was your first? Believe it or not, we all have our scorecards, ways to sum up our relationships. Sarah, 4 months, 2 weeks, 12 fucks, moved away, didn't go with her. I want you to close your eyes. No, really, do it. Now raise your hands with the notches on your bedpost. Unless you've got Alzheimer's, you will know exactly the number of people you've slept with. Men, in particular, may be able to tell you the amount of times. There are three certainties. As the years go on and the relationships develop, you may lose track of the number of times. If you're Tom Jones, you may even forget the number of people, but three facts will always spring to mind. Your best, your worst, and your first. That was it for me. A little spot of immortality in someone's personal history. I was there first. I popped their cherry. I planted their flag. I was the first man on the moon. The morning after, I would make their coffee, butter their bagel, kiss them on the cheek, and they'd never see me again. That perfect moment had come, and whilst I would never boast, they would usually come. However, that perfect relationship, that special someone they'd been saving themselves away for, he wasn't me. Oh, you hate me now, don't you? That was the sport I played. Let them love me and leave them. Why? Some cruel satisfaction in watching their bubbles burst? No, it was simple. Although it is something of a popular myth, I found it to be true. Virgins become strangely attached to the ones who broke their dams. I don't know the scientific reasons, if any, behind it, but through a combination of endorphins and pheromones, the head becomes overpowered with a love delusion longer than it should. It wasn't just the prospect of a clingy other half that scared me. It was the discovery of walls covered in my picture and schoolgirl ramblings of love and forever in the back of notebooks that did. Because when that bubble popped and my mask came off and I wasn't the Mr. Right the pheromones had created, that would be something that created true misery. That would be something that ruined lives. The little game I played was a challenging one. Not least the whole seduction part. Anyone who tells you that women like this or that is a moron. They've made one of the easiest mistakes to make. Women should not be treated as a whole, but as individuals. When visiting the island of Galapagos, Darwin deduced that for each orchid, there would be a bird with a beak specifically evolved to drink its nectar. I, on the other hand, wanted to play chameleon, representing what they thought would be their perfect mate. Someone they can entrust the gift within their loins to. Of course, there was always the trouble of finding out if they were untouched. Nights out are often a fruitless exercise. Lonely hearts a little better. Sometimes you could spot a potential prey just walking down the street. Ah, the religious. The foundation my industry is built upon. No matter how strictly we abide to the rules we make for ourselves, at the end of the day we're all animals. Animals with desires and hopes and dreams. For moments I could reignite them. The nights are the worst. No matter the amount of people you fill your days with, come night you're totally alone again. In waking it may seem like you're holding something with a heartbeat, but that morning kiss was comprised of your own drool. It was at night that I would pounce, when she'd let down her hair, let down her defenses. In time, I would let her down. The games we play with ourselves are the most dangerous ones. The games like, I'll get married by 28, and I'll be in that job by next year. These are the games for which we punish ourselves, brand ourselves failures. As for my little game, the end was in sight. Who would have held on longer than she? She was the grand prize, the last part of my collection. Although she would inevitably enjoy the experience a lot more than me. If I ever wanted to be satisfied I had won, she was the proof. In for a penny, in for a pound. Hi, I don't suppose you remember me. I am quite aware of the inappropriate time of the call, but you said, were I to need any help, I could phone.
Oh, well, what is it you need help with?
Well, this woman I've been seeing for a while is growing weary of just having, you know.
No, I'm sorry, I don't follow.
Well, it's kind of embarrassing, but she's eager to have sex.
Well, that's perfectly natural.
Yes, but I want to save ourselves for marriage.
Really? People are still doing that?
Well, I am.
It's been a while since I had one of these. Well, I guess you're wanting to do that and she's not willing to wait, then she's not the right one for you. But I mean, you know, it's kind of good. The whole sector, or so I've heard.
You mean you've never...
Well, you know, I devoted my life to God, but God can't, well, you know...
Give you multiple orgasms?
Well, that's one way of putting it.
Anyway, thanks for your advice. You must want to get off to sleep.
No, I'm okay, actually, if you'd like to keep talking.
I had caught me a little fishy. That bit about the orgasms were like the hook, and she could see where the conversation might go. The signs were all there. She'd chosen to continue it. We talked for about an hour and a half. We talked about love, we talked about sex, about the modern world and the kids of today. We decided to meet at a Christian cafe the next day. Jesus may have been able to feed thousands with the fish and a bit of bread, but their bacon butty failed to fill me up. Tummy rumbling, I walked her to her church. May I ask you a highly personal question, Irene?
Yes?
Are you still... I'm sorry, I'm not quite sure how to...
I remain holy in the eyes of the Lord.
Wow.
I know, I'm pathetic.
No, I mean, wow. You really must have such strength of character to keep... Well, you know, especially growing up in the 60s.
I didn't agree with all that hippie crap, but I still enjoyed the music. I'm one of those few people who actually remembers Glastonbury 1974. You know, you shouldn't take the Bible so seriously. It's a very old book, you know.
You don't really believe that.
All I'm saying is a nice handsome fella such as yourself should, you know, put himself out there.
I was just raised differently.
Better, I would say.
I don't know. Maybe I'm being idealistic, but I just want to give it away to someone who respects me, who loves me. Not just because of the hormones in my body or because it's what's expected.
Yes, but that person may never come along, Chuck. I mean, you don't buy the cow without tasting the milk.
I'll meet you for lunch tomorrow.
Oh, that would be nice. Would you like to come in and pray?
I would, but the second I come in, I'll set on fire.
I'm sure you won't.
I'm off to work. I'll see you tomorrow. Over the next couple of weeks, we engaged in what the old folks would call courting. She would slip in the occasional, "Surely you don't want to be hanging around with an old coot like me," which I in turn would laugh off. We would talk about most things, religion, theatre, books. Sex had begun to leak into our conversations. We talked about it in a giddy and secretive way, like two little boys who just found a Playboy under their father's bed. My prize was within my grasp, the game almost won, my quest almost complete. A few more meetings, I felt sure that would be all that it took. We'd become closer and closer, and I'd prepared myself mentally for the night when it all went off. It would take discipline. It would take nerve. It wasn't going to be pretty, but it was going to be mine. The question rose in my mind, what next?
Daniel!
What would I do with...
Long time no see. How have you been?
Fine. I've been just fine.
Still working for OEC?
No, I moved on. I'm freelance.
Oh, that's good. Anyways, it was nice seeing you.
What now? I guess I could collect Peter Rabbit figurines.